let's talk about pricing your lash services for profits. Hi everyone, Mandy Jacobellis here. I'm the founder of the LAshX Method. I'm also a salon owner and a lash artist. And today I want to talk about how to best price your lash services for profits. Although I'm in the business of creating lash extension products that are healthier and safer, I'd like to think my real business is helping entrepreneurs, or most specifically women, grow their businesses. That's my real passion. And the number one thing I hear from our lash accounts or our LAshX partners is that they feel like they can't charge what they're worth because of competition. So we've done a few videos, and I'll put the links below on business strategy and things like that. But today I wanna specifically talk about how do you set your pricing. The number one mistake I see accounts making is maybe they look at their neighbors or what other people are charging and they price their services the same. And that's a really flawed method, because you need to make sure when you're choosing your pricing that not only are you covering your expenses, but you're also making a profit and it's worth your time. Our most valuable, our most restricted resource is our time in the room. So if you're working 8 hours a day, 10 hours a day, you need to make sure per hour you're making what you need to make for that day to cover all your expenses, and then you obviously want to profit. That's why we're in business. We all love lashing. We love making other people feel and look great, but at the end of the day, you want to make sure you have the money you need to keep your doors open and maybe go on vacation now and then. So how do we figure out our pricing without just looking at the competition? The first thing I really recommend is you need to do an Excel sheet. Yes, you guys are all gonna hate me, but you really need to make an Excel sheet of all your expenses and then add 10%, because we always forget something. But really look at your real world expenses, not only your rent, employees if you have them, insurance, taxes, parking, supplies, you know, anything that actually is a cost, you know, the coffee your client drinks when they come visit. And you want to tally all that up. And then you want to think about what you need to be making an hour. And then you want to add those numbers together. That's what you need to make per hour in your room. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take the service you're providing and think about how long it takes. So if a full set of lash extensions takes you 2 hours, you want to take that number and multiply it by two. That is what you should be charging for your full set. I know many of you out there are way undervaluing yourself and undercharging because you think you need to compete on price based on other people. So with the LAshX Method, what we try to teach and train our accounts to do is not compete on price, but to add value for the clients. As women, as customers, everyone I've ever met is willing to pay an extra $50 to have to come do a service half as often. Think about your hairs, think about your nails. If you could pay $50 more and do it half as often, would you? I bet you all would say yes, because time is also, as a customer, our most valued resource, right? So if you charge a little bit more, but the product lasts longer, the client actually saves time and money, but you're maximizing your money per hour, which allows you to make more profit, if that makes sense. So it's a win-win, because your client's saving time and money and you're maximizing your hourly pay. And that's really the point of being in business. You want to maximize your time in the room. It's really hard if you've already set your prices to go ahead and raise them, because nobody likes to get the same thing for a higher price. So when you do decide that you're going to increase your prices or change your pricing, you really need to give them a different service or a different value, and make that really clear to the client. And I would keep your current price point, your current offering, and say, hey, we can upgrade you to this new product. It lasts twice as long, it's $50 more, and it's going to actually make your natural lashes healthier. Get your clients to upsell or self-select a higher price point, rather than just saying, hey, we're doing the same thing, but we're going to charge you more for it. The other tip I often give is when you're coming out of school, a lot of times people think they need to price low because they're a beginner. Well, it might be true that you want to maybe set realistic pricing because you're slower, you're just learning. It's really hard to raise your price as you get faster. So what I recommend is figuring out that net, what you think you need to make, and then giving a special or promotion for your first so many number of clients. For example, if you know you're gonna wanna charge $300 for a full set and $200 for your fills, then maybe for your first 20 clients or 30 clients, you're giving them a special promotion of 30% off or 50% off if they bring a friend. There's different strategies you can use in marketing and promotion to get people in the door when you're a little bit slower without lowering your price, and then the client eventually knows that that promotion will run out and they eventually will be paying the higher price point. So how do you know exactly what to charge? Besides figuring out, you know, your costs and what you want to make, you need to figure out who your target customer is and what they want to pay. The reason why I say that is because there's a different customer and a different service for everybody. You need to know who your target market is. And any of you that have watched my videos or my last Lashes and Lattes live on Instagram, you might have heard me say this comparison. So I apologize if I repeat myself, but I think it's the best analogy. There's a hair salon called Fantastic Sam's, Great Cuts. These hair salons, it's probably anywhere from $20 to $30 for a haircut. Here in Beverly Hills where we are, there's places you can get your haircut that are $500 to $1,500. In both businesses, and they could be a few streets apart or even on the same block, they have vastly different price points. So what's the difference between what you get at a Fantastic Sam's or a Great Cuts versus this $500 to $1,500 haircut? In both cases, your hair is gonna get shorter, but the experience is vastly different and the results might grow out different. The ambiance might be different. There's a different value there. And so you wanna make sure when you're figuring out your pricing, you think about who your target customer is and what they value. Are they valuing you being the least expensive lash place, or are they valuing you being the healthiest or the longest lasting or the closest to home or the prettiest spa experience, or maybe it's a one-stop shop where they can get everything done at once. But you really need to know who your target customer is and what they value. Some people value significance and they want to go to a place that costs more because, I mean, there's probably lots of factors, but one of it's probably that it costs more and they want to say they go somewhere that costs more, or they want to go to the same place that, you know, J-Lo goes, or whatever celebrity, or wherever in your town, maybe it's, you know, the sports athlete, whoever it is. People have different reasons for choosing different types of businesses. So location is not the only factor on price. And so many times I'll hear you guys say, well, the neighbors are only charging this, so I really can't charge that much for my area. So I thought I would do this video to help you guys figure out what it is that you should be charging. And remember, it's your time. So for me, what is the value of that? If I'm working, it's time away from my two young children, it's time away from my husband, it's time away from other things that I could be doing, other businesses that I'm running. So that has a price to it. And so you really need to figure out what that value is for you and what it's worth. Because what you don't want is a job where you're resentful, where you're like, oh man, I have to go to work and I'm away from this and I'm missing that and it's not really worth my time. Whenever someone says it's not worth my time, that is another word for saying you're not charging what you're worth. And I think specifically as women, and this I say women because the majority of entrepreneurs in the lash industry right now are women. I think we're different as a gender in that we do put ourselves on sale a lot. Perfect example is we kind of make decisions more emotionally where men don't do that. So an example might be like, hey, my cousin's best friend really needs lashes, but her husband just divorced her and she's going through a tough time. Do you mind doing it at half price for her? You know, a friend asking us, or our friends or family expecting us to do free services because we just love lashing so much. Men would just say, no, this is my rate, you know, here's my fee. And it's not an emotional thing for them. They don't feel bad. Whereas women, we kind of like feel bad. Oh, we don't want to charge too much. We put our own emotions on things sometimes. Sometimes we put our own budget on things. Like, wow, that's a lot of money for me. I wouldn't be able to afford $300 for lashes. Well, it doesn't really matter what your budget is. It matters what your target customer's budget is. So I like to do this video and I like to specifically talk to women because I think we have the biggest challenge of really charging what we're worth. And I think women in general are the most important part of the population for being entrepreneurs because women put 80% of their income back into the community, back into their children, back into schooling. And so we as a gender, really, it's really important that we bring in our full potential. So if you don't do it for yourself, at least do it for other people and know that that money is going back to your family. It's going back to your communities in the ways that you do that. So it's really important to charge what you're worth. So that's my little soapbox. I'll get off. But if you guys need more coaching, I'm always available. You can call me. For our partners, we do offer free coaching and support. If you're not yet a partner, we'd love to talk to you about that. If you just want not to use our products, but you want some business coaching, we do offer that as well. And I hope some of these videos add value to you guys. My goal is really to help you succeed in your businesses. So every Wednesday, we're coming out with a helpful video. We also do Lashes and Lattes live on Wednesdays. You could log in on Instagram and ask your questions live, and I'm there to chat. So with that, I will say thank you so much for tuning in. If this was helpful, please subscribe. If you want to put comments below and topics you want to see in the future, we'd love to hear that. And go out there and raise your prices and make some profits. And I want to hear how it goes. Thanks, everyone.